1800 hours, Pakistan Standard Time. Assalamu alaikum. This is Radio Pakistan. The news read by Friha Hassan. First, the headlines. Prime Minister says a good time is coming for Kashmiris that will lead to their ultimate freedom from Indian occupation. Special Assistant to Prime Minister on Information has said India has badly failed to suppress the voice of the freedom of armless Kashmiris by the use of brute force. Turkish President will visit Pakistan to address joint sitting of Parliament on the 14th of this month. In occupied Kashmir, thousands of people poured in to attend the funeral prayers of three martyred youths in Srinagar, Islamabad and Budgam districts. In China, the coronavirus crisis has deepened with death toll soaring to 563 as authorities struggle to contain the outbreak. First test of two-match series between Pakistan and Bangladesh will be played in Rawalpindi tomorrow. And now the news in detail. Prime Minister Imran Khan says a good time is coming for Kashmiris that will lead to their ultimate freedom from Indian occupation. Addressing Kashmir Solidarity Rally in Mirpur this afternoon, he said the purpose of his visit to Mirpur is to give a loud and clear message to more than 8 million besieged Kashmiris that today whole Pakistan stands with them. He said the stupidity committed by Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on 5th August last year in arrogance will result in ultimate freedom of Kashmir. Imran Khan said due to election compulsions, India raided Balakot to martyr a few trees. The Prime Minister said Pakistan shot down Indian jets last year and even released the captured Indian pilot as a goodwill gesture because we believe in resolving the issues peacefully. Warning India, he said any misadventure launched by New Delhi will result in its own defeat. He said more than 200 million people of Pakistan and its battle-hardened army will teach India a hard lesson and this will be a grave and final mistake of Narendra Modi. The Prime Minister also inaugurated an education complex of Kashmir Orphan Relief Trust in Mirpur Azad Kashmir. Later, the Prime Minister visited classrooms and hostels and interacted with the children. Earlier addressing the rally, Foreign Minister Shah Mahmood Qureshi said the whole Pakistani nation stands and political parties stand with the Kashmiri brethren with one voice. He said Foreign Office will continue raising its voice for oppressed Kashmiris at every international forum. In his address, Minister for Kashmir Affairs Ali Amin Gandapur said Prime Minister Imran Khan, by playing the role of ambassador for Kashmir cause in true sense, has highlighted this lingering issue in such a way that now it is reverberating around the world. Special Assistant on Information and Broadcasting Dr. Firdaus Ashikavan says India has badly failed to suppress the voice of freedom of innocent and armless Kashmiris by the use of brute force. Talking to media in Mirpur today, she said Prime Minister Imran Khan stands like a firm and compact wall with the Kashmiri people for realization of their birthright to self-determination. She said voices are echoing in every nook and corner of Pakistan that Kashmir will become Pakistan. Turkish President Recep Tayyip Erdogan will address the joint sitting of parliament on 14th of this month. This was stated by Speaker National Assembly Asad Kaiser during the National Assembly session today. The Speaker said he will also hold consultations with all the parliamentary leaders on the matter. Parliamentary Secretary for Finance Zain Qureshi told the House during question hour that the process of revamping the economy through structural reforms and stabilizing measures such as broadening the tax base, reforming the public sector enterprises, and reducing the fiscal deficit has been started. Parliamentary Secretary for Commerce Alia Hamza Malik told the House that both Pakistan and Iran have conducted negotiations over the establishment of barter trade mechanism and promote cooperation in the fields of customs, agriculture, and industry. President Dr. Arif Alvi has stressed the need for taking care of children in terms of their nutrition so that they can be saved from stunting and malnutrition. Addressing National Nutrition Conference in Islamabad today, he said malnutrition is present in every class because variety of eating is very narrow. The president said breastfeeding is the best source of providing healthy nutrition to our children, terming malnutrition statistics alarming. Dr. Arif Alvi said 29% children under the age of 5 years are underweight and 54% are anemic. This is Radio Pakistan. Pakistan hopes that US-Taliban peace talks would come to logical conclusion, leading to intra-Afghan negotiations. Foreign Office spokesperson Aisha Faruqi, in weekly briefing in Islamabad today, said this was the subject of US Special Representative for Afghanistan Reconciliation Zalmay Khalilzad during his recent visit to Pakistan. She said Pakistan is closely following the developments regarding peace talks between the two parties and believes it is a good improvement that Taliban have shown willingness to talks and called for reduction in violence. Replying to a question, the Foreign Office spokesperson said, "We are aware of protests held outside Pakistan embassy in Kabul and the matter has been raised with Afghan authorities." The Foreign Office spokesperson said Organization of Islamic Cooperation has been one of the strongest proponents of Kashmir cause. She said several OIC resolutions have been passed on different aspects of Jammu and Kashmir dispute, including human rights violations taking place there. Aisha Faruqi said OIC held ministerial meeting on the sidelines of UN General Assembly session in September last year, and the independent report issued by it condemned the human rights abuses in the held Kashmir. On the upcoming visit of Turkish President Recep Tayyip Erdogan to Islamabad, the Foreign Office spokesperson said it is a scheduled visit of fixed duration. She said Pakistan and Turkey enjoy warm and cordial relations and both stand by each other in times of need. Aisha Faruqi said so far, only 4 Pakistani students have been affected by coronavirus in China and their condition is reported to be stable. The U.S. Consul General in Lahore, Catherine Rodriguez, has said that the United States gives importance to its relations with Pakistan and is willing to bolster the bilateral ties. She was talking to Chief Secretary Punjab, Major Retired Azam Suleiman Khan, who called on her in Lahore today. In occupied Kashmir, thousands of people poured in to attend the funeral prayers of 3 martyred youth in Srinagar, Islamabad, and Budgam districts. Indian troops martyred the youth Khatib Ziaur Rahman and Fayaz Ahmed during a cordon operation in Lavepura area of Srinagar the other day. As the bodies of the martyrs reached their native villages in Waghama, Lapura, and Ut, an influx of people turned up for their funerals. The mourners shouted pro-freedom and anti-India slogans as they took the bodies of the martyrs to the local graveyards. Israeli troops shoot dead a Palestinian during clashes in the occupied West Bank today. The clashes erupted when Israeli troops came to Jenin to demolish the home of a Palestinian. In another incident, 12 Israeli soldiers were injured when they were hit by a car in Jerusalem in a suspected Palestinian attack. Turkey has urged Russia to immediately stop the Syrian government's attacks in Idlib region. Talking to reporters in Baku today, Turkish Foreign Minister Mevlüt Cavusoglu said Russia is a guarantor country for the Syrian regime and Turkey expects it to stop Syrian government's attacks in Idlib. He said a Russian delegation is expected to visit Turkey in the wake of a Syrian regime attack on Turkish troops in Idlib. And now cricket. The first test of 2-match series between Pakistan and Bangladesh will begin in Rawalpindi from tomorrow. The match will start at 10:00 hours Pakistan Standard Time. Radio Pakistan will broadcast live ball-to-ball commentary on the match. And finally, the weather. Mainly cold and dry weather is expected in most parts of the country during the next 24 hours. However, very cold in Upper Khyber Pakhtunkhwa, Kashmir and Gilgit-Baltistan. To end the news, here once again are a few of the headlines. Prime Minister says a good time is coming for Kashmiris that will lead to their ultimate freedom from Indian occupation. Turkish President will visit Pakistan to address joint sitting of Parliament on the 14th of this month. In occupied Kashmir, thousands of people poured in to attend the funeral prayers of 3 martyred youth in Srinagar, Islamabad, and Budgam districts. first test of two-match series between Pakistan and Bangladesh will be played in Rawalpindi tomorrow. And that is the end of this news bulletin. For more news and analyses, log on to our website radio.gov.pk and also watch live video streaming of our bulletins on the link facebook.com/radiopakistannewsofficial.